All righty. An official welcome to everyone joining us this morning. Nathanial, just do a little check for me. Just nod your head if you can hear me.
I can hear you.
Excellent. Okay, that is Nathanial Bibby, who is our guest speaker this morning. I'll tell you a little bit more about Nathanial in just a moment, but just some official welcomes to people who are joining us. So it is just turned 8 a.m. on the east coast of Australia. So those of you who are joining us in Melbourne, Sydney, Brisbane, Canberra, and places along the east coast, a special warm welcome to you. It is just past 7:30 a.m. in the Adelaide and Central Australia. We have some people joining us from the west this morning, where it's just come 6 a.m. So welcome to those of you joining us from Perth and in Western Australia. Also, we have some people viewing this morning from Hong Kong. Also, Kuala Lumpur. We have people in China. Good morning, Li Ping Hao. Li Ping Hao in Shanghai. Special good morning to you, Li Ping, who I was chatting with last night. So I hope it's a great day. It was very hot in Shanghai yesterday. She was telling me. Singapore. We have Rob Salisbury joining us from Singapore this morning and a team of salespeople up there. It's 10 o'clock. They're ahead of us again in New Zealand. So welcome to all of those you joining us from New Zealand. Now, it's actually the day before, it's Wednesday in some parts of the world. People joining us from the United Kingdom, London. Hello again to Melissa Shedden, who's one of our regular viewers, who's joining us from the United Kingdom with a bunch of other people in the UK. It's just after 3 p.m. in Pacific Daylight Saving Time in Los Angeles in California. We have some people joining us there. I think we have John Robinson and his team and a number of people around the west coast of Australia. Across on the east coast of the United States, did I say Australia? I meant the United States. It's just after 6 p.m. in New York time. We do have quite a few people joining us there. We also have some people joining us in Canada. Hello to Felicity Brace Girdle, who's joining us there. Anyway, welcome all out of the way. It's a real pleasure to be presenting this subject to you today on the subject of LinkedIn, the mysteries of LinkedIn, hopefully solved for some of you. Because I don't know about you, but for me, LinkedIn is just massive. And I must admit, up until when I had the pleasure of meeting our main guest speaker this morning, shouldn't say main guest speaker, but one of our guest speakers this morning, LinkedIn was still a mystery to me until I met this gentleman, I guess going on around about 12 months ago when he shed an awful lot of light on this subject for me. I knew it was there. I thought I probably should be in there, so I had a profile, but I wasn't quite sure why I was there and exactly what I should be doing with it. And then I had an opportunity to sit down, have a chat with Nathanial Bibby, who is Managing Director of Bibby Consulting. And Bibby Consulting and Nathanial has assisted more than 3,000 businesses across Australia, in fact, around the world, is my understanding, with their sales and marketing strategies. With clients in Southeast Asia, I'm just looking here, and has lived for a little while in Hong Kong. So I'll welcome you to open your microphone, Nathanial, and come on screen, and we'll say an official good morning and hello to you.
Good morning, everyone, and thank you very much for your kind introduction, Wayne. It's a pleasure to be here this morning and share with you some of the things that I've picked up along my 12 years of experience in digital marketing and lead generation. And I guess we've all seen the internet evolve over the past 12 years, and what was effective back then is no longer effective now. I started my career in search engine optimization, where we could very quickly get a website from page 10 on Google to page 1 and generate literally 10 leads a day was what we were achieving in my first role. And sure enough, it wasn't long before that was ineffective and competition moved in, and it was not so easy to get to the top of Google, and we moved into Google advertising. Now, when you're in the online marketing space, the cost per click for something like web design is as much as $30 per click now. So again, becoming more effective and less hard to generate a return on investment. So when I saw social media come about, I did play around with Facebook a little bit, but found it very hard to have the patience to make money out of posting things like what you had for breakfast and what you did on the weekend and that kind of thing. So when I came across LinkedIn, I quickly decided that it was the platform for me. It is really the location where people are there to do business. You can get a very, very quick response rate and a very immediate result.
Yeah, Kristian. Yeah, hello, Kristian. How are you? Kristian has just come on the scene here. Look, I'll quickly introduce Kristian, then we'll come back to you. Nathanial, I see that Kristian kind of interrupted your flow there a little bit. Kristian is the managing director and founder of a company called We Are Video, in fact, known as Look Media up until a little while ago, and growing very, very quickly. Kristian's company specializes in production of some of the well-known television commercials that particularly people here in Australia are very, very familiar with. He works with some of the largest corporations in Australia producing their television commercials, but also specialises in and is one of the preferred providers now for low-cost video solutions to meet the growing demand for online video. And online video really is very, very powerful way of selling and marketing these days. And one of the reasons I've invited Kristian to join us, and Kristian has been on a previous web TV program talking about video production and the use of video, is because I'd like to tie it all together this morning. So we're going to come back to you in just a second, Nathanial, and get you to continue. So we're going to talk with Nathanial about how to get the most out of LinkedIn and how to get people to flow to your website. And then, of course, what to do with them once they have arrived at your website. And one of the best things to do these days is to, in fact, have good quality video there so we can handle the people appropriately, have the maximum impact on them when they do, in fact, visit our website. So I'll just get you to test your sound there, Kristian, and just move your camera down a little bit so we don't get quite as much space above your head.
There we go. How's that space going?
Well, we can still see your face, so it's okay. It's okay. Okay, Nathanial, we will come back to you. Just move down a little bit more, Kristian. You know what I'm like. I'm a perfectionist when it comes to video. So just tuck it down a little bit more. But we'll come back to you, Nathanial. Please continue. And I'll just throw one to you. How long, Nathanial, has LinkedIn been around now? It seems like it's been quite some time, but what was the quick history of LinkedIn? How long has it actually been out there? And I know, you know, a lot of our viewers this morning have been signing up, working on their profile for many years. It just seems like a long time. How long's it been?
Sure. I think, I am actually guessing, but I think it'd be officially around 2004. I know I joined in 2007. In the last couple of years where it really started to pick up in America, in Australia, we've now got pretty much 95% of the white-collar workforce.
Okay, yeah, we lost your video feed there for a moment, possibly an internet speed situation at your end, but what percentage did you say of white-collar?
I was just saying that there's 7 million members in Australia now, which is quite phenomenal. It's about 95% of the white-collar workforce.
Wow. So yeah. In terms of marketers and salespeople, our target market is very much on LinkedIn these days.
Yeah, absolutely. All the high income earners are on there. 85% of the members are there to do business. And it's affecting decision making. Wayne, would it be appropriate for me to share my screen and just run through a couple of slides at the moment?
Yeah, look, please do. We seem to be having a little bit of internet speed problem there with you. Keep freezing, but we'll see how we go. Kristian, I'll just get you to mute your microphone because that's possibly also interfering there a little bit. Thank you, Kristian. Okay, Nathanial. Yeah, please, Marmins, if you've got some screens or slides that you'd like to share with us that might help us to understand what you're talking about, that'd be great. Go ahead.
So this is just what we were running through just then. 1 in 3 professionals on the planet are on LinkedIn, as well as 7 million in Australia. And 49% actually find LinkedIn to be a good source of word of mouth information on brand experiences. So what we're seeing is social media is becoming more and more important because there's all this herd mentality. People want to get third party endorsements. That's why, you know, people aren't so interested in going to your website anymore, because on your website, it's all very well that you can tell people how good you are and, you know, all the reasons why they should do business with you. But on LinkedIn and Facebook and all these other social media websites, it's actually a lot of your clients doing the selling, and if it's a party reasons as to why you should be doing business.
So can I just pose the question, how effective is LinkedIn compared to the other social media areas like Facebook, like Twitter?
Yeah, we're seeing the results are about 5 times as effective as the other mediums, mainly because people are there to do business. The industries that work the best are generally business to business. However, there is some good business cases where business to consumer will work as well, particularly with the likes of financial services companies where they target high income earners, solar energy companies, anyone who's can sort of hone in on their target market can do extremely well on LinkedIn. And what we find is with any marketing medium where there isn't a huge amount of competition, we do see good results. So as a general rule, if you're staying ahead of the curve, you are going to get some outstanding results.
Okay, keep going. Keep explaining what you've got on the screen.
Okay, well, look, I won't bore you with just a whole bunch of statistics, but if you can see that last little bullet point there, we're actually seeing 1 in 3 marriages now are actually originating from the internet, which I found absolutely astonishing. What's going to happen with business relationships moving forward? Now, if anybody on the call has ever Googled somebody before they've met with them, or even done the experiment of Googling your own name, you may find that the number one search result is your LinkedIn profile. If it's not, there's probably a good case for you to get your profile optimized. What I actually tell my clients in this instance is, if somebody is doing their background checks on you prior to a meeting or prior to going into a business relationship with you, in this instance, your LinkedIn profile is actually more important than your website. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Okay, that makes sense. So that you call that optimization of your LinkedIn profile?
Correct, yes. So no different than a website. You should be going through for keywords. The way that Google's evolving, it is becoming very much a search engine for social media websites. And we all know that it's pretty hard to compete with a social media website, which is content coming from everywhere. So we're finding now that it's actually a lot easier to get your LinkedIn profile to rank on the first page of Google for various keywords than it is your website.
So I guess really from our viewers' point of view, predominantly salespeople, small business people, or even large business operators viewing this right now, we should be intelligently using LinkedIn, correct me if I'm wrong here, but this is the way I see it, intelligently using LinkedIn to find out about our prospects, to find prospects out there, to find out about the human beings, the prospects themselves before making contact with them. I think gone are the days when salespeople should be saying things like, I'm calling you and could you tell me a little bit about your company? We should know quite a lot about the individual, their background, what they've done in their previous career. We can also find out that information from obviously just visiting their website, but also it's possible to look at company profiles, of course, these days on LinkedIn. So we'll talk a little bit about that. So intelligently understanding who our prospects are, finding our prospects on LinkedIn, doing searches, targeting people specifically, understanding who's who within a company. For example, if we look for their profile, I'd like you to talk a little bit about this, how we can actually find out who's who within a company and the various levels of membership required in order to do those kind of things on LinkedIn, if you wouldn't mind telling us a little bit about that. Also, I'd like you to comment, if you would please, on how important is our profile, to actually spend some time to get our profile right? Because I don't know about you, but these days, if I'm going to do business with somebody, if I'm thinking about purchasing something from them, one of the first things I do is actually go and look for them on LinkedIn. And if they don't have a profile on LinkedIn, I've got to really think, you know, how up to the minute is this kind of person? You know, is this person really somebody that I'd like to do business with? Are they at the leading edge in terms of thinking and doing business? So people too go and have a look at our profile to find out about us. And we need to be sure that when they go there, that what they find is going to be appropriate and be supportive to us rather than detract from us. You might even like to comment a little bit about Facebook and things like that, because I have a professional Facebook entry there, because I was conscious some time ago when I didn't know much about Facebook. For example, I set up a Facebook profile, put pictures of my dog and my kids and all that sort of stuff there. And we need to, again, be careful in all social media that people go looking for us. And if you're kind of a younger person like me, and I won't say that I go out partying, but some people go out partying and they put photographs and things there. I mean, people will see that kind of stuff and it will detract from our profile.
Your LinkedIn profile is the cornerstone of your sort of, I guess it's your personal brand window to the world. And can you see that's what I put up on the screen?
Absolutely.
There?
Wait. Great. Let's data turn your camera on again, please. Let's have a go at that.
Okay. We're living dangerously.
We are indeed, but gee, we're in the 21st century. Go ahead.
Okay, so what I wanted to do was give the viewers today something that they can take away and implement right away. You can see there, the first thing I've got is an optimized LinkedIn headline. What I see is people make the mistake of putting in their job title, their company name, which more often than not do not have any relevant keywords for the business. Oh, yeah. What I'd like to encourage people to do is put something a bit more descriptive in there that people might actually use as a search phrase. So, for example, I've got in mine LinkedIn lead generation, social media speaker, LinkedIn training and marketing, you can see there. And you can see that I've actually used the full amount of characters that you can to fill that headline out. And so that's actually quite an important area of your LinkedIn profile. Okay. I would say it's the second most important, because your first is definitely your profile photograph. Mm-hmm. If you haven't got a professional one, then that's quite important to go ahead and do that. Also to add connections, you'll notice that when you get over 500, the number of connections that your LinkedIn profile will display will be 500 plus. Yeah. We've noticed there's been a lot of research released around this herd mentality, which is going on the internet, where people want to be connected with other connected professionals. And we find that crowds follow crowds online. And in order to increase your probability of generating leads through your LinkedIn profile, it is quite important to have over 500 connections. Mm-hmm. And even keep expanding it beyond there, because your LinkedIn profile is only ever going to be as strong as the network that you have. So yes, quantity is important, but also pay close attention to quality of your network and your LinkedIn connections. The other thing is, make sure that you always complete the contact information on your LinkedIn profile. And the reason for that is LinkedIn will reward people that do complete these sort of areas of their profile, because quite often people will use things like your postal code as a search criteria when they run their searches. So, for example, to put that into context, if I was looking for a video marketing professional in Melbourne, and I would put in the postal code 3000. Now, if Kristian doesn't have a postal code in his LinkedIn profile, he's not actually going to show up. So I know that Kristian does, because we helped him with his LinkedIn profile. But if you don't, then you're not going to be in the mix. So it's quite important that you do this so that you don't miss out on lead opportunities and opportunities to do business.
Okay, good advice there. What else would you like to tell us about your profile?
Just a couple of other pointers there before we move on is, add websites. You can choose when you put in a website generic labels such as, my company or my blog or personal website. If you go to other, which is one of the other options, you can actually put in keywords here as well. It's one of the very quick ways to make sure that your profile is getting optimized. So these are, one, two, three, four, five. Five of the steps that we've mentioned so far. We have a process of 22 steps that we go through in total to optimize a profile. Mm-hmm. The sixth one there is register your LinkedIn web address, so you can customize your URL. It's very powerful as well. If you haven't done that already, then make sure you do register your web address, which should really be your first and last name, in order to make sure that people can find you when they do search for you on the likes of Google and things like that. Mm-hmm. And once you have gone through the whole process of, optimizing your profile and written your summary and all that kind of thing, LinkedIn can be extremely powerful for lead generation. And I want to just run through a very quick three-step process, which we've used before. And if Kristian doesn't mind, I'll use his business as an example. Kristian is a client of ours, and we have generated a number of leads from him. Kristian, do you mind if we share the number of leads that we've generated for you?
More than happy, and more than happy for you too. And just on that, after my profile was optimized by Nathanial and his company, we found there's about 100% increase just in the leads that were generated as a result.
Yeah, fantastic.
And this is one of the reasons I brought Kristian on here this morning, because Kristian is actually a client of Nathanial's. In fact, I met Nathanial through Kristian. And it's had a major impact on Kristian's business and the growth of Kristian's business in recent times. So back to you, Nathanial. Keep telling us about this.
Okay, excellent. So what I've brought up on the screen here is a three-step process of find, connect, and engage. Now, the first step in a lead generation campaign would be to use the search features on LinkedIn to hone in on your target market. And for Kristian, I think we started in the financial services industry. So we were targeting financial services companies between 1 to 49 employees. And we were looking for the directors of those companies. So all of a sudden, we've got straight to the decision maker, and we could contact them about Christian's video marketing. Now, the wrong thing to do would be to send them all a message on LinkedIn when we haven't even connected with them and say, hey, this is who we are. This is all the services we offer. We'll give you a 15% discount if you buy before 7 o'clock and all that sort of stuff. What we actually did is build a relationship with them by connecting with them first so that they became new connections on LinkedIn. And then once that process was complete, we moved into the engage side of the process, where we actually contacted them, showed interest in their company, and shared with them some key statistics of how video can actually increase your conversion rates online.
Okay, that sounds interesting. In fact, I have a question here. By the way, I'll just invite those viewers online here that if you have some questions that you'd like us to answer this morning, please use the Q&A function. You should see the Q&A function there on the screen. I'll just check in a moment that it is actually turned on, but you may care to just test that for me by using the Q&A function. I have received a question in advance from a gentleman by the name of Ken Ridley, whom I've known for quite some time. Ken is involved in the media industry and the radio industry with Fairfax Media. And that was one of the questions that Ken raised. He said, you know, he doesn't want to be seen as spamming his LinkedIn community. So I guess what you're saying there is very relevant in terms of the communication that we do have with members on our LinkedIn community. And just to verify here, are we able to send a message these days to everyone who is on our list, or just people who are in our special interest groups?
Sure. To answer your question, if somebody is a LinkedIn connection, you are able to send them a message. If they're not a LinkedIn connection, you can send them a message through InMail, yes, which is LinkedIn's products, and you can pay to do that. And another way is you can also join groups that your prospects are members of and message them through the groups as well. However, a word of warning, sending messages to people that you're not connected with, we find is about half as effective as sending messages to people within your network. Sure. So we actually suggest this process of connecting with people first before we go through the engage process. In response to Ken's point there, we agree completely, and we do believe that spamming your network is the wrong thing to do.
Yep.
This is your social database, and you should be treating it as an asset to your business and be nurturing it and looking after it like, you know, it's going to be with you for the lifetime of your career. Mm. And when you contact them, make sure that you are delivering value and it's not all about you. If I had to give you one key learning to take away from you from this call about online marketing in general, is it's not about you. It's about the customer. And I stress this in everything we do. When you're writing a message, make sure that you're using the word you more than you are me, and make sure that you are giving a lot of value as well. If somebody hasn't asked for you to contact them, then as a general rule, you should be delivering some sort of value, whether it's an invitation to a free information session like this, or an offer to give them some insights into how they can improve their business.
Indeed, and you mentioned groups. Now, we have a number of groups. We have three groups that we have actually created, and that is the Worldwide Top Gun, Worldwide Sales Coaches Group. We have one for sales managers, and again, we called it Worldwide Top Gun Sales Coaches Group. We have another one, Worldwide Top Gun Sales Professionals Group. And so we set up three groups, and we initiate discussions on those groups. We send useful tips and ideas to people in those groups. Can you maybe comment on the value of setting up your own groups to share information with, and what we should be doing with groups, and also what we should be doing when we belong to other people's groups. For example, I know it's been very inappropriate for us to post promotional type things in other people's discussions, in other people's groups. So would you like to comment just a little bit about the use of groups?
Absolutely. So I wouldn't recommend that it's something that you delve into without thinking it through. As you know, Wayne, from managing your own groups, it is quite a big commitment. We also manage a group called the Entrepreneur Club Australia and New Zealand, and it is quite quite a full-on task to manage it and make sure the content is good quality. At the end of the day, the key things that group managers are looking for is that people are posting things which do add value. So promotional stuff is normally frowned upon, and we find that it doesn't generate as strong results. If you are commenting on groups and it's not your own group and you are actually participating in discussions, we find that that can be an extremely great, good way to get your brand in front of your target audience. So I would suggest, if you are posting, to post something of interest that adds value rather than looking for something which has a call to action at the end of it. And then also, commenting on other people's discussions. If somebody comments on your post, then by all means, make sure you reply and keep the conversation flowing, because what we find is when you have more engagement and more comments and more likes on your post, it actually moves towards the top of the group's posts, and which means you start to get this snowball effect, and it can actually go into a situation of becoming viral. So I'll give you an example, like of a LinkedIn publisher post that I saw somebody made up in Sydney, and he was just outlining some of the reasons why he preferred LinkedIn to Facebook. And the title of the article was "Why I Left Facebook." Now, quite creative, he decided to put a picture of Mark Zuckerberg in the article rather than himself. And when you tie the photograph of Mark Zuckerberg to the "Why I Left Facebook" title, it gave the impression that perhaps Mark Zuckerberg had handed in his resignation and he'd left Facebook, which obviously is pretty quite a hot news topic. So he went to get from getting a few views on his profile a day to literally getting about 150 odd thousand people view this article within a space of 7 days.
Wow.
So that's really the power of LinkedIn.
Yeah, and could I just ask the question, and I'd like you to interact a little bit with Kristian shortly about the specific strategy that you used with him, if you don't mind, so we can use that as a case study. Sure. But there are different levels of membership, are there not, with LinkedIn? So I think I've got, tell me what they are. I know that I have more than the basic one, but again, I'm not sure that I'm actually utilizing that very, very effectively at the present time. I know I'm paying a little bit extra for it. I started to use it, and then I've sort of drifted away. So tell us the different levels of membership and what we can do with each.
Sure. Okay. So LinkedIn has a premium option, and if you are going to upgrade, I think the best value for money is the Business Plus option, which is just about, I think it's $57 per month. However, generally that when people are figuring out how to use LinkedIn and they don't feel like they're getting the results that they'd like, that's the first place that they go to look for solutions. Just word of warning that LinkedIn Premium is not going to all of a sudden just create a flood of leads into your profile. What it actually does is just enhances any strategy that you may be using already. So what we generally suggest is start using LinkedIn for business purposes, getting a return on investment, use some of these strategies that we've discussed here, find, connect, engage. And then when you can see that it's actually working for your business, that's actually a good time to then upgrade and take advantage of the first 30 days free, which LinkedIn offers. Mm-hmm. We are an advocate of the premium account because all of our clients use it. And then from there, there's a lot of upgrades. We've got something called LinkedIn Recruiter, which mm-hmm. is the highest level of LinkedIn paid account you can have. And we've got something like 800 in-mail credits, which we actually don't even use because we know that the find, connect, engage model is a lot more effective. So don't be fooled into thinking that in-mails are the answer to, success on LinkedIn. It's far from the case. One of the reasons why I believe that there's not so much LinkedIn training readily available from LinkedIn. Is, you know, their whole business model is geared around these upgrades, and as long as people believe that that's going to be the answer to their lead generation strategy, then that's what people keep doing. But the reality is, you don't actually need the premium account to make money from LinkedIn. What I believe is we'll see the platform evolve, and it'll be harder and harder for us to add people as connections that we don't necessarily know personally. You know, as LinkedIn evolves and they start to monetize a lot more of the business activity that's happening on LinkedIn. As you know, Wayne, traditionally LinkedIn has been regarded as a recruitment tool. And so many professionals still have like an exact copy of their CV as their LinkedIn profile. You know, I was talking to somebody about LinkedIn a while back, and they said only 16% of the people using LinkedIn are actually using it for recruitment purposes, which leaves 84% that are using it for business purposes. So it's only more recently that LinkedIn's catching on to the fact that there's actually a lot more salespeople and business professionals and CEOs using LinkedIn than there is recruitment. So if you're on LinkedIn to get more customers and all you have is a copy of your CV on your profile, you're probably not going to get many leads. So if you start to think of it as a tool to promote yourself and as a professional and apply a strategy that achieves the outcome that you're looking for, then you're going to get a lot more success. And when you do get that success, it's important to measure the results.
I'd like to ask you about that in just a second. But a really good example of that is Kristian's profile on LinkedIn. So viewers may care to have a look at that sometime. That's Kristian, Kristian Curcio, Curcio, I beg your pardon. Because I looked there last night, I wanted some information actually just to do a little intro for Kristian. I had a look there, and of course, it's been very well written. Doesn't read like a CV. He actually gets into explaining what it is that he does, what it is that he offers. So it is great for selling his services. Yours is also a great profile, as we would expect it to be. I've got a question here from Jason, who's asking, can other LinkedIn contacts you have actually see who else you've got? Who else you're connected to in your LinkedIn profile?
Oh, great question. It's something that you can customize in your privacy settings. So you do want to be careful about that. Make sure that people can only see your shared connections. Otherwise, you could depending on what industry you're in, I suppose, you could run into a case where people are actually, you know, competitors could be seeing all of your connections, all of your clients messaging from there. Mm. One of the things that I would like to touch on in regards to, you know, Kristian's project is we found that the using video as a way of explaining what it is that you do can be a fantastic way of selling without selling. Wayne, I'm sure you know what I'm talking about here, where rather than, you know, me telling you exactly how we do everything on LinkedIn and how fantastic we are as a company, what I'd prefer to do is send a link to a YouTube video where that's all explained by the video. So it's a third party link, which is explaining what we do in a very, very clear manner. It's only like we had a video done by Kristian's company and it was no longer than 2 minutes. And for me to explain what it is that we do will take a lot longer than that. So sending the link is actually a great way to, in a nutshell, explain what you do to a prospect. And then also we incorporate video within the LinkedIn profile. So we're actually making this like a very integral part of the process when we build a LinkedIn profile to have video there rather than just these, all these chunks of text, which explains what you do. I think, you know, more and more videos are going to become prominent online as a way to just explain the benefits of doing business with certain individuals.
Okay. Well, we might talk with Kristian, have perhaps you and Kristian discuss that subject, if we could. I'll just get you to stop sharing your screen, if you would be so kind, Nathanial. That's good. That gets us full screen again. Looks a little bit more interesting than that one that was there. Kristian, this is your specialty, I guess. Would you like to just tell us why is video so effective and how much more effective has it been measured to be compared to websites that have a whole lot of text? And probably a really good example of that is we worked with Kristian to upgrade our website a little while back. For those of you who visit our website, you would notice it is populated by literally hundreds of videos there these days. Wherever we had text explanation of things, we pretty much replaced them now with video. And a lot of the video there was, of course, shot with Kristian's company. So over to you, Kristian.
Thanks, Wayne.
Nathanial, turn your camera on. Nathanial, we'll try again for your camera. Makes it a little bit more interesting. But thanks, Kristian. Sorry to interrupt you. Go ahead.
No, that's all right. Really good question there, Wayne. Basically, people now in business, we're quite time poor. We're through the likes of YouTube, we've become quite lazy. And we do watch a lot more content these days. So basically, the video has been, our customers are telling us that it's about up to 80% more likely to increase their conversions from someone viewing the video rather than a PDF or a slab of text, as Nathanial pointed out earlier. And the reason for that is quite simple, is by having a professional video, the message is short, sharp, concise, and stands out with the key points. Especially, we found ourselves in particular, we with the request and engage model that Nathanial runs you through, is that a lot of people were just finding that, you know, there is a lot of text on LinkedIn, and there's a lot of people trying to request with you. There's a lot of people trying to engage, and there's a lot that comes up in your newsfeed there. And we found that by actually having a message ourselves and practicing what we preached, allowed us to have a much more qualified and higher engaged engagement request based on the video that we put out there. And we've found a lot of our clients are finding the exact same things which Nathanial's company acts for.
Okay. And I think some people are a little reluctant to get into video because well, you tell me, what's the things you hear from customers? We have a lot of salespeople out there right now, so let's talk in terms of objections that you sometimes get from companies that you talk to about video. I noticed there is some reluctance by some of my clients to actually get into video. I've been kind of advising them to do this for some time, but they still haven't yet made the move. So what tends to hold people back, and what can you do about it to help them?
It's funny that with new clients that have never dabbled in it before, there is a bit of resistance around the fear of, oh, is it going to be too hard? What if I put the wrong information in? Am I not going to be able to redo it? Is it going to be too expensive? Firstly, you know, the cost of getting these done is somewhere in the vicinity of, dependent on what solution, from, you know, $1,000 to sort of $3,000 is the most expensive we've seen. But our team is basically is set up with a professional at every level. We're not a one or two man band. We do have professionals to hold your hand along the way. It's not an uncommon thought to go through. And what we actually, the way we actually do set things up is where our producer will hold your hand and get the information out of you that's going to have that core message that's going to reach, work for your customer, you know, for now and however long moving forward. In fact, yesterday we were talking to a customer that has been using the same video at his forefront for about the last 12 months. Mm. Whilst he's changed little bits and pieces around his website, which you can do easily, the video core message has been the same. And with that, we do hold all the files, and we're actually able to make changes very, very easily along the way as you go. If something changes in your business, you know, you don't need to worry about that, you know, getting it right 100% the first time. And with that, we actually find once either a salesperson or an organization's had a video done, it's almost like they get an appetite for it, and all of a sudden they find they start using them at all the different touch points with their clients along the way. And the reason for that is they find that it actually makes it a lot easier for them to conduct their business, and find they don't have to repeat themselves.
Look, it's also much more personal too, I think. You know, I deliberately am the face of our videos so frequently. And of course, you can work with people to help them to do that. I know I've been in your studio, and your people are very patient and able to help people who've possibly not been on camera before to do that. But of course, you don't have to be an on-camera personality. You can, again, provide talent to do that. Also, you've got some tremendous animated stuff that tells the message so well. And obviously, you know, it's well written, put together really well. So there's so many different options and ways of going about that, isn't there, Kristian?
Correct. Look, there's no one solution for that, that, you know, that fits every company. There is, we do have a suite of offerings that basically our professionals, our team will help you guide you on the right path to what's going to get the best outcome for what you're trying to achieve. But that doesn't necessarily always mean that it's a that it is a presenter. It might be a voiceover with some imagery, some motion graphics. But the key to it is actually making sure that those points are executed effectively and sharp. We do have, unlike most other video companies in the country, we do have a full-time team of directors, producers, script writers, and editors. So it's not the one person that's sort of sitting there doing the whole lot, and it is all about making sure that we achieve that right outcome for you. I think Nathanial, obviously you're a big advocate, and obviously it works for you very, very, very well, Wayne. But I think Nathanial had some good successes off some videos he didn't even try to promote, which he might want to share with you a bit later on.
Nathanial, would you like to comment on that? Well, it's because we spoke about it last night.
Yeah, I couldn't believe it. When I first got my first video done by Kristian, I threw it up onto YouTube. And this is before I even decided to share it or send it out to my database. And I got a phone call, and it was from somebody that I'd actually met a couple of weeks ago. And they said, "Hey, Nathanial, we should really catch up about this LinkedIn training stuff." And I said, "Oh, that's interesting. What? Why is now a good time?" And he said, "Well, I just saw your video, and I thought that it looked like something that we could discuss." And I said, "It's really interesting that you say that, because we actually did have this discussion. We did have a meeting about this a couple of weeks ago, and you decided that it wasn't right for you, and now all of a sudden you want to have the same meeting again." And I called Kristian up afterwards, and I said, "Wow, that's a true testament to the power of video, that somebody who decided already that it wasn't right for them is now calling back and saying that they, you know, want to meet up." And they eventually did do business, just purely because of the professionalism of the video and how it actually probably explained what we do better than I did.
Look, it really humanizes the business, doesn't it? Now, I don't know whether you're joking yourself, but you said you got into a taxi and the taxi driver, or knowing you, it'd probably be a limo, said, "Hey, you're that guy who's going to be on the Top Gun Web TV show tomorrow morning. I recognize your name. I recognize your face. I've actually seen the video." So, you know, I guess we have some salespeople and business people who are moonlighting or something like that. But yeah, I mean, it really does. And it is quite funny. I don't speak at many conferences these days because most of our business is done online. But when I do speak at conferences and I walk through a company, it's amazing the number of people who come up to me and introduce themselves to me and start chatting because we're old friends, as if we're old friends, because we are old friends. They know my face. I've seen my face for years. In fact, at a business recently where I was going to speak to the group, I explained to the gentleman who was introducing me, just do a basic introduction because I'll tell them more about me. I'll introduce myself. He said, "You don't even need to worry about that. They all know you. They've been looking at your videos for the last 2 or 3 years. It is an incredibly powerful medium for building rapport and putting that human face on your company. And the fact of the matter is, your competitors are doing it. If you're not doing it, your competitors are doing it, or will be doing it, particularly if they're watching this today. So, and another comment I'd like to make is that until you actually jump in, it's a little bit like some technology around, until you jump in, start doing it, you really don't even understand what's possible. It's a little bit like getting into technology. I always used to, and I still do, I'm always at the leading edge of buying gadgets and technology because I discovered that and unless I jump in and actually do it, I don't fully understand the potential of it. But once I get in there and start to use it, I then see all the amazing things that I can do with the technology to get a good result. I think using video, using LinkedIn is probably very much the same. It's a matter of making a decision, making a commitment to jump in there and actually do it. So would you like to comment on that? And we're getting a great feed from you now, Nathanial. You're not freezing up there at all. about your strategies in working together, how you've done that. And
if you don't mind, Wayne, I might just, before Nathanial kicks in, it's interesting what you're saying there and about the success that Nathanial had. We had a long-term client that we've been doing television commercials for many, many, many years. And they're in the spa industry. And they expanded into a new section of the business, and they were trying to, which was selling heat pumps. And they had taken off the license for these pumps from a competitor of theirs. And their competitor had sold one of these heat pumps in 12 months. And if you looked at the tech specs, there is no reason why you wouldn't have saved your money. It was cheaper. It heated it up faster. It cooled it. Everything just stacked up. They couldn't sell it. So this gentleman's name's John. He said, well, Kristian, you know, I think the key here is because people just aren't understanding how simple this is. Can we, you know, put something together that's going to work? So we put together a brief video for them, and would you believe it that they sold a container in just a weekend?
Wow.
I thought that was excellent, and that's common with a lot of the feedback that we're getting, that just the return on investment is lightning fast.
Well, one of you...
I'm sorry.
I was just going to quickly say one of your clients is True Value Solar, which our viewers in Australia certainly would know is almost a household name all over Australia now. The advertisements are everywhere, and you know they're one of your major clients, Kristian. And I think it's okay for me to say that they're probably the main reason for their growth is the enormous response and success that they've had of using video for advertising, television advertising, and website. So anyway, back to you two guys.
Yeah. I just wanted to mention that we've just decided to get We Are Video, Kristian's company, to produce a string of videos for us for people, clients that have already come on board as a way to educate them through our process and actually provide the welcome video, explain step-by-step how they need to do their reporting, manage any upsells for us. So what we're actually doing is eliminating the need for like an additional account manager, so to speak, to be able to provide them with that information. Is actually going to increase our client retention rate. And I think that, you know, LinkedIn and video marketing both serve a purpose in doing a lot of the pre-selling prior to sitting down with an existing client or a new client. And I think you could probably, it's be safe to say that LinkedIn and video marketing could do about 70% of the sale. And by far the biggest mistake that I see people make is they don't follow through on the last 30%. And so if they're not getting the sales conversions at the back end, then the whole thing falls down. So it is very much a collective approach, and by no means is video marketing and is LinkedIn marketing superior to video marketing and that kind of thing. It's actually a holistic approach, and it does actually come back to what you do, Wayne, and sales coaching and having a sales process to be able to funnel those leads into converted sales and actually get the outcome that we're all here for.
Well, look, that is absolutely true. And Kristian and I do work together with some of his clients now. And one of the things I do want to make an offer here on this morning for those of you who are watching this is that one of the things that we train in specifically is how to handle an incoming telephone inquiry or web inquiry and turn that into a sale. In some cases, a sale over the telephone. In some cases, a face-to-face meeting where it's easier to go through that sales process. But sadly, some companies, you know, they spend money on TV advertising, radio advertising, website stuff. Their phone rings or they get website inquiries, and the person says, "Hey, what's your best price on such and such?" And you know what the salesperson says? They give them the price, and the person at the end of the line says, "Well, hey, thank you very much for that. I'll get back to you." And they don't. Can I suggest to our viewers, if you handle inquiries like that, or if you handle inquiries like we'll send you out a brochure, don't stop doing that. You know, that is not the way to do it. We work with some of the most successful companies in Australia, particularly franchise organizations, and improve their conversion ratio dramatically. In fact, some of our clients have built their businesses based on the systems that we put in. For example, we developed the system for Foxtel when Foxtel first started here in Australia as to how to handle the inquiries that were coming through, how to improve the conversion rates. So if you're spending money on video production, you're spending money on other things to get your phone to ring or get web inquiries, and your people have not been trained how to convert those inquiries into sales, can I suggest look into this? It is a skill. It is a strategy. We have a 12-part strategy to do it very, very well, and the conversion ratio, it is not uncommon for us to see our clients double, treble, quadruple their sales based on handling their inquiries much more effectively. And Kristian and I now work together, and it's a part of what our relationship here now, that when Kristian organizes video production for a company, he gifts to them some training from Top Gun. So we actually go in there, we look at what their current sales process is for handling inquiries, and we actually provide some training that is gifted by Kristian. Doesn't even cost anything at all. Sure. In fact, that's one of the things that I do want to say, and I'm going to ask you gentlemen in just a moment, because I know the time is coming up to the hour, and whether you have some advice or some special offer that you'd like to make today to people who are viewing this. But one of the things that I'd certainly like to offer is that if anyone would like to do business with Kristian and do business with Nathanial and put those two things together, and you set in place your LinkedIn strategy, you set in place your video strategy, I will gift to you some training. And looking at your sales process will not cost you anything at all. Why would I do that? Because it builds my relationship with my client base, and that's what it is all about. I'm a great believer you need to give to get, but you give without the expectation of getting back. You build the relationships with your clients, and it all works very nicely that way. Back to you guys.
Yep, Nathanial, you might want to kick that one off, and then I'll wrap it up.
Yeah, sure. Okay. Look, what I'd like to do for everybody that's taken the time to join us on the call is offer a review of your LinkedIn profile. And what I'll actually do is spend 30 minutes on a call, much like this, coaching you through what you can do on your LinkedIn profile to make it stand out from the crowd, get to the top of the search results, and make sure that it's converting visitors to opportunities. And I can see the link here that's coming up on the screen. Thanks, Wayne.
Keep going.
So what you can actually do is book a meeting straight into my calendar by following the link that's displayed on the screen there for a 30-minute LinkedIn coaching opportunity. Now, we charge $500 for these, but for anybody that's attended the call or got a copy of the recording, we're going to leave this offer open for the next 7 days. It's going to be actually completely free. So again, much like yourself, Wayne, we're all about adding value to our existing networks, and this is a way of doing it. So one-on-one LinkedIn coaching with me personally for 30 minutes, completely free. So make sure you take advantage of that opportunity if that's of interest to you.
Okay, I'm going to put that link, that information below the recording. So those of you viewing this now that didn't get that, came on the screen there before, there'll be a recording available at our website. Everyone who's on this will receive the link shortly. Well, that is by tomorrow, where they can actually go and view it if you want to go and have a look. All of our previous Top Gun Web TV programs are online at our website. You simply go to the homepage on our website, have a look there for the link that says Top Gun Web TV. You click on that and you can watch about the last 12 different episodes as I interview various people, and there's lots of great information there. And the recording of this one will be there within the next 24 hours, probably by around about noon tomorrow at the latest. Now, a leading question here for you. In fact, we've just got a couple that have come in, the Q&A's here. Yeah. I've got one from Ken Ridley who asked, could we give some approximate price range on basic promo videos, Kristian? So over to you, and you might explain what your offer is today as well.
Thanks, Wayne. Good question, Ken. We do have a range from sort of around the $700 mark up to about $3,000 that suits probably 90% of Australian businesses. We have custom products as well, but for about 90% of Australian businesses, that's around where you're at. And again, it is different strokes for different folks. Our main objection is to make sure that it's the right solution for you that's going to generate a result, rather than a fight to the bottom on the cheapest. Because it is very easy to gauge the results, and if the difference is only a couple of $100, well, in business, it's really not worth the second thought. We do have, the industry that we're in, we don't very often do offers, but we are extremely confident in what we do. We do get results for all of our clients, and I'd like to probably put forward a completely risk-free offer to viewers who are watching from either Bibby or Top Gun subscribers, is that we would like to offer where basically we're happy to donate a video or do a video at cost price, and then if you're happy with the results, pay us the balance in sort of 4 to 6 weeks once you've started to see some results and are happy with the outcome. That's how confident we are.
I think that's a great offer, Kristian. It takes away any risk there at all. And it is ridiculous. You know, $700, you know, your services start at $700, go up to a few thousand dollars. I mean, that's affordable by anyone. That is very, very low cost, because as some people may have in mind how expensive video production costs used to be in the past. It certainly has come down. It's come down mostly through volume and expertise and technology these days. And Kristian is right on the leading edge of the technology there and able to do that. And by the way, with technology being the way it is, you're based in Melbourne, Kristian, but I know you have clients all over Australia, I think even internationally, because it really doesn't matter these days where anyone is.
Correct.
You can shoot production even locally for them, I guess, bring it in, put it all together with your production facilities in Melbourne. And the good thing is you can tweak, and your people are very patient about this. So once something is shot, that's not it. That's, you know, it can be tweaked, it can be changed, it can be improved. And the cost of doing that is sometimes, zero, because you're doing it, you're tweaking it before it goes there. But, you know, 3 months, 6 months down the track, you decide you want to change a little bit. Again, you're able to do that, and it's a great service. Correct. And to make it risk-free like that is great.
Correct. In fact, just yesterday, we actually received a request from a customer that was watching the previous Top Gun webinar that we did with you, Wayne, and that was probably some 6 months ago now, and they just needed some basic changes. You know, it actually didn't cost them a thing. So we put that through yesterday and sent it straight back to them on the same day, which is great. We are able to service nationally. And without intruding into the workplace as well. We do have both for anyone that's watching today that I'll be speaking with myself, or Michael Pollard, who is our client solutions national manager nationally. So either us, and perhaps there's just a question there from Don Coddle there.
Yeah, you can see it. Yeah, what's he say here? Can we have the website details to Kristian and Nathanial? Yes, by all means, I'll let you guys give it yourself. It will be below the recording. However, Kristian, your website is very easily found.
Wearevideo.com.au.
So just wearevideo.com.au for those who are perhaps listening to this rather than watching it. And Nathanial?
Bibby Consulting Group, Bibby Consulting Group.com.au. If you would like to contact me directly, the best place to find me is LinkedIn. I'm on there, believe it or not. If you can find my profile under Nathanial Bibby.
Indeed. Okay, look, gentlemen, I'm going to thank you very much for your time, not just the time that you put in here with us for an hour this morning, but the preparation time and time that has led up to this, and I appreciate it very much. We do these on a regular basis. We don't do it as a direct profit generator or sales generator. We do it to build relationships with our clients, which is the power of video and doing things like this. And again, those of my clients who are watching this and have heard me say this before, I implore you to get video active and do this kind of stuff. If you are able to deliver some value to your clients like I'm doing here now, I'm not blowing my own trumpet here, but that anyone can do this. This is really simple stuff to do. And of course, we're using zoom.us. As our video platform here this morning. I think it is better than anything else that's out there. But it's pretty simple to put together a web TV program like this, where you share ideas with your customers, with your prospects, build the relationship, deliver value, and don't try to flog anything. You're simply delivering value in doing this. And by bringing in experts, such as I've done this morning with Kristian and Nathanial, who in the end can add value through the information they give, and then I think it's okay for them to make some kind of a special offer at the end. I'm not on commission. I get nothing out of it. It's just purely if I can help my clients, that's what it's really all about. So again, gentlemen, thank you very much for your time in being with us this morning. Thank you to our viewers. I'll come back to you for final comments in a second, guys. But thank you to our viewers who are viewing all around the world. I see the people that we have online there, and we still do have people online from China. I see Malaysia. I see we do have people in the United States. We do have people in Canada, the United Kingdom. Thank you for joining us again. And it's really great to have that community around the world. And of course, we know so many more people view this online afterwards. They view the recording. So please tell your friends, associates about it if you enjoyed and found there was great value in what we just did here today. Pass along the link that will come out to you by email to today or tomorrow. Pass it to them, so spread the word. And I think it's okay if we extend the offer to anyone who watches this video within the next, say, 7 days, who perhaps wasn't on the call this morning, but they can still take advantage of the offer if they watch the recording.
Absolutely. Thank you very much, Wayne.
Okay, any final comments from Kristian and Nathanial apart from goodbye?
No. Thank you very much.
Thanks for your time, guys, and look forward to speaking to a few of you in the next 7 days. We unfortunately don't have the luxury of being able to offer that kind of service for too much longer because, frankly, we don't need to, but we are happy to help and get everyone started and on board. It really does help. Between LinkedIn and what we do and a lot of my services, it is fantastic.
Mm. Very good. Hey, and I'll finish this Top Gun Web TV program in the way that I normally do by saying, have a great day, make it a great day. Remember, it absolutely will be the day that you make it. Don't leave it a chance, make it a great day. Bye for now.
Yeah. Bye-bye.
See you guys. Bye-bye.